Good morning, everyone. Welcome to our time of worship on this Palm Sunday, one of the highlighted days in the life of our Lord as he entered the city and people were raising their hands and clapping and putting palm branches in front of him, a time of great celebration. Let's enjoy this time together then, because after today we enter into Holy Week, go through the struggles and the death of our Lord, ending, as you know, in that final climax with the resurrection to give us life and light and hope and peace. So welcome to this service. Join in as we sing, as we share, as we listen, as we pray, and may the Lord bless you and the Spirit of God be at work in you, doing his good pleasure.
Bienvenidos. Tenemos un servicio muy especial. Si es la primera vez que está, le damos la bienvenida a usted. Hoy celebramos la entrada triunfal de Jesús a Jerusalén y el comienzo de la Semana Santa que va a culminar con la resurrección de Jesucristo. Hoy tenemos un servicio muy especial con bautismo, nuevos miembros. Vamos a cantar canciones gozosas y también vamos a escuchar la palabra de Dios. Así que alégrese, gócese y tenga expectación de ver lo hermoso de Dios en su vida también en este día. Así que le damos la bienvenida.
สบายดีสมัยเลิศและจะท่านขอแสดงความดีอกดีใจและขอขอบคุณพระเจ้าที่พี่น้องได้มีโอกาสเวลาเข้ามาสถานที่แห่งนี้บ่อนี้สําหรับตอนสัปดาห์นี้พวกเราจะพากันเสริมฉลองวันที่พระเยซูเพิ่นได้เข้าไปในเมืองที่พี่น้องฮู้เนาะถ้าพี่น้องเบิ่งนั่นก็เช่นและจะท่านในกรุงเยรูซาเล็มและจะท่านพระเจ้าก็พากันเซเลบเรตหรือว่าเสริมฉลองเกี่ยวกับเรื่องพรามซันเดย์ เป็นมื้อที่พระเยซูเพิ่นได้เดินเข้าไปในเมืองนั้นและจังซั่นมื้อนี้สําหรับตอนสัปดาห์นี้พี่น้องก็สิได้มีความสมสื่นยินดีและพากันยกย่องสรรเสริญถวายเกียรติพระเจ้าถ้าว่าเป็นได้ก็ยกมืออันนาร้องเพลงมวลนํากันและจังซั่นแล้วก็เสริมฉลองนํากันและจังซั่นขอให้ทุกๆคนนั้นจงอันนาให้เกียรติซึ่งกันและกันในการที่พระเจ้านมัสการต่อพระเจ้าและจังซั่นขอให้ทุกๆคนนั้นได้รับพระพรร่วมกัน
May you bow your head and pray. I'll pray. เพื่อจะได้พากันสรรเสริญยกย่องถวายเกียรติแก่พระเจ้าองค์เจ้าข้าดังนั้นขอพระองค์เจ้าทรงเจิมสติปัญญาให้แก่ผู้ที่รับฟังของพระองค์เจ้าข้าหรือว่าจะเป็นผู้ที่จะแบ่งปันพระธรรมก็ดีพระองค์เจ้าข้าดังนั้นขอพระองค์เจ้าทรงเจิมสติปัญญาให้แก่ทุกๆคนหลายนั้นโดยเทอญพระองค์เจ้าข้าดังนั้นพวกลูกจึงขอกราบมอบอธิษฐานไว้ทุกชีวิตอยู่ในห้องนี้ไว้ในพระนามชื่ออันยิ่งใหญ่ขององค์พระมหาเยซูคริสต์เจ้า Amen.
We'll invite you to stand with us as we begin our time together in worship. Praise is rising, eyes are turning. Praise is rising, eyes are turning to you. We turn to you. And hope is stirring, and hearts are yearning for you. We long for you. When we see you, we find strength to face the day. In your presence, all our fears are washed away. They're washed away. Saves us. sound of hearts returning to you. We turn to you. In your kingdom, broken lives are made new. You make us new. 'Cause when we see you, we find strength to face the day. In your presence, all our fears are washed away. They're washed away. Sin and shame, they were like prisons we couldn't escape. But he came and he died and he rose. Those walls are rubble now. Remember those giants we called death and grave. They were like mountains that stood in our way. But he came, and he died, and he rose. Those giants are dead now. This is our God, this is who he is. He loves us. This is our God, this is what he does. Took our breath away. Faith so weak that we could barely pray. But he heard every word, every whisper. Now those altars in the wilderness tell the story of his faithfulness. Never once did he fail. What he does, he saves us. Bore the cross, beat the grave. Let heaven and earth proclaim, this is our God, King Jesus. Who pulled me out of that pit? He did, he did. Who paid for all of our sin? Jesus, who pulled me out of that pit? He did, he did. Who paid for all of our sin? Nobody but Jesus. Who rescued me from that grave? Yahweh, Yahweh. Who gets the glory and praise? Nobody but Jesus. Who rescued me from that grave? this is what he does. He saves us. He bore the cross, beat the grave. Let heaven and earth proclaim, this is our God, King Jesus. He bore the cross, beat the grave. Let heaven and earth proclaim, this is our God, King Jesus.
Amen, amen. Feel free to grab a seat.
Amen. Good morning and welcome. Bienvenidos. Sabaydi, Samayla. It is good to be together in the house of the Lord and to gather as one church, four congregations. And this morning we have a lot to celebrate. We have some baptisms in a moment. I'm excited to welcome 10 new members to in baptisms at Butler Church. God is moving in our midst and working, and maybe even got a little taste of that on the way in. Did you visit and get some baked goods and get some goodies to help support our women's ministry? They're getting ready to go to a camp and raising funds. And we just recently did the same thing for our youth because they all have already attended a winter camp. And because of many of you buying some egg rolls, did you enjoy some of that, some pho? They worked hard to raise funds so that they could get up and go to camp. And so we have a short video to highlight some of their impact of what happened. And then our youth leaders are going to come up and say a few words. So a quick video.
Hi, my name is Alicia, and our highlight of this week was learning to be selfless. And our main focus of the verse was 1 Corinthians 10:31. So whatever you eat or you drink, and whatever you do, do all to the glory of God.
Hi, my name is Elijah, and this is my first time attending Christian Camp, and I want to thank you guys for the support and prayers.
Hi, my name is Jordan. I want to say thank you for everyone who made it possible for us youth to come to camp this weekend. Thank you.
I think I learned to be more grateful this week at camp.
I'm thankful for the people who taught me a lot of stuff more about Jesus Christ. I also learned about more about how the Bible, about Mark, 1 Corinthians. A lot more about Mark, 1 Corinthians. Like, so whether you eat or drink or whatever you do, do it to the glory of God. That's very inspirational to me. And I thank you guys and thank God.
All right, hi, I'm Paul. I learned how to be more selfless and how to forgive people. Yep.
My name is Akira, and this week I learned the difference between appreciation and love.
You give life, you are love, you bring light to the darkness, you give hope, you restore every heart that is broken. Great are you, Lord, it's your
All the earth will shout your praise. Our hearts will cry, these bones will sing. Great are you, Lord. All the earth will shout your praise. Our hearts will cry, these bones will sing. Great are you, Lord. It's your grace.
Good morning. I would like to thank you. As you can see in the video, our youth had lots of fun. They were in the Word, and worship was the part that everyone was participating in. That was the best part. And I was afraid of the zip line. I can see in the video. So he had to count down for me. So I was like, okay. But you know, you have to be a good example. So we're doing things for the youth. Even I'm terrified. But anyways, thank you to our Butler Church friends and family for supporting and making this possible for our youth. And go ahead. A few of our youth,
sorry,
the first time they shared.
I gotta write this on my notes. My name is Albert from the youth group. First, I just want to thank everyone who made it possible for me to attend Heartland Camp for the first time. During my camp, I learned to be selfless to be. Think less about yourself more than others, and also accept Lord Jesus Christ as my Lord and Savior. Thank you. We have fun at Christian camp. There was like zip line, paintball. Technically, there was like volleyball I played most, but sometimes I was not trying. And that's it.
My name's Paul. This is my first time going to winter camp, and I was thankful to come to this church and everything. So, amen.
Hi, I'm Ella. This is kind of a last minute thing, so bear with me. Camp was really fun this year. We went with our newly found youth group. This is our second year going all together, and it was really fun. Like they were saying, we had lots of activities that we were doing. We had zip lining, paintball, lots of crafts. I think one of our highlights was being able to spend time together during our cabin times, just playing games, just connecting with one another has been really good. Before a winter camp, we definitely had some struggles of connecting with each other, and this camp definitely helped bring us together. The speaker that was there this year, he talked a lot about being selfless and what it means to help others and put others before yourself. That is definitely really hard for people our age, especially in a world where we are brought to learn about how to put yourself first, how to make your own goals, how to bring yourself up before you help others. And so we had to learn what it's like to be Christian in a world where you have to learn how to help yourself first before others. So camp was really great this year. We loved it. We hope to go to next year. And we want to thank everyone for all the funds that they put in to help us get this experience going.
And I couldn't have done all this without Shelly reminding me about, you know, the deadline, and we contact the Heartland. So Shelly, can you come up here? We would like to thank you.
Thank you.
testimonies of what God is doing. He's on the move, and we thank you for those of you that prayed, that gave. All together, we do this. We lean in together and to worship Christ, to serve Him, to love Him, to grow in Him. And so it's exciting to see our youth grow. It's exciting to see our church grow. This morning, as I mentioned earlier, we have 10 different people that are joining us in membership and baptism. And we, this morning, want to just highlight what it means to be baptized, what it means to join Butler Church. And I'd like to read for us Romans chapter 10, verse 9 through 15. It says, if you openly declare that Jesus is Lord and believe in your heart that God raised him from the dead, you will be saved. For it is by believing in your heart that you are made right with God, and it is by openly declaring your faith that you are saved. As the scriptures tell us, anyone who trusts in him will never, never be disgraced. Jew and Gentile are the same in this respect. They have the same Lord who gives generously to all who call on him. For everyone who calls on the name of the Lord will be saved. Amen. What a wonderful truth for us to know that by faith, by believing and by confessing, it is by belief and confession that we are saved. By believing in our hearts that Jesus is the Son of God, that he came and he lived and he taught us what it meant to live according to God's word and according to his will. And not only that, he laid his life down for us, dying on a cross, resurrecting to new life, that now by belief and by confession, anyone, I love that part, says anyone, everyone can be saved. And what a gift to share together the beauty and wonderful testimony of baptism this morning. To share that together as one church. There's a reason we do this at a combined service. We normally meet in four different services every Sunday morning. We are somewhat divided in that aspect, but we are one church. And this morning, we share together that fact that no matter our language, our culture, our background, our age, our education, the size of our bank account, whatever way the world measures us, together in Christ, we are one. And this morning, we recognize the testimony that will be shared through baptism, a confession of belief in following Christ, that these 10 people are committing themselves to. And we also welcome them into membership to be part together with all of us, Butler Church. And so to begin this morning, I want to invite Virginia to come and join me at the front this morning. Virginia Longoria is going to join me here. I don't know if Leticia, you want to come as well, her daughter. Virginia and Leticia both are going to be baptized this morning. Because our baptismal is painfully hard to get to, we this morning are going to baptize Virginia with pouring of water. A wonderful way to give testimony to her belief. And Virginia shared her testimony last week along with the others. We heard a heart for God and for Jesus. And it's been a joy to get to know you, Virginia, to know your heart for Christ, to follow him and for his church. And this morning, I want to ask you, do you believe that Jesus is the Son of God who came and lived and died and rose again? Yes, you do. And do you also this morning confess that he is Lord and Savior of your life and you are committed to following him? Yes, I do. Amen. Well, according to your confession of faith, your belief in him and profession before all of us, I now baptize you in the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. You may lean forward. Blessings. Blessings. Thank you. Mm-hmm. the rest of our baptisms are going to proceed from the tank. But before we do, we have one more testimony. Last week, we were unable to hear from Giovanni, and we were able to have him share just a brief part of his testimony and reason for why he is being baptized this morning. And so that will play on the screen, and following that, Pastor Elbio will be baptizing Giovanni, as well as two others from Amor y Fe, and the rest from Common Ground this morning. So watch the screen.
Hi, my name is Giovanni. I wanted to get baptized because my brothers and sisters, I saw how they behaved right after they got baptized. They started acting different, like more devoted to Jesus. And I also want to get baptized because Jesus is my Lord and Savior, and Jesus died on the cross for our sins. And I also want to get baptized because Jesus commands that you get baptized, and that's why I would like to get baptized. And I pray to Jesus every day, and I worship Jesus, and I let people know that Jesus is Lord and Savior.
Giovanni, congratulations. So do you believe that Jesus is Lord and he went to the cross and died for you?
Yeah.
Have you received him in your life and you are committed to follow him all the days of your life because he's your Savior?
Yes, I believe.
Okay. According to your confession, I baptize you in the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Great moment. Did you believe that Jesus is Lord and he went to the cross and died for you and God rose him from the dead on the third day?
Yes.
And you received him in your life and he's your Savior, your Lord, and you're committed to follow him all the days of your life?
Yes.
Okay. According to your confession, I baptize you in the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Shocked. Congratulations. I'm so happy for you.
Thank you.
Did you believe that Jesus is Lord, that he went to the cross and died for you, and
yes,
he rose from the dead?
Yes.
And you made Jesus the Lord of your life, and he's your Savior and
yes,
Lord, and you follow
yes,
him all the days
yes,
of your life?
Yes.
Okay. According to your confession, I baptize you in the name of the Father, Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Sure, I want to come up here. Well, good morning, everybody. Buenos dias. My name is Maria, for those of you who don't know me. This Friday, on Good Friday, we are having a outreach at Summer Park Apartments. We actually partner up with Summer Park Apartments throughout the year. We come alongside them, or they come alongside us, to help us out with events and other things that are going on. But this Friday, we're partnering up with them. We're actually coming alongside them, and we're helping them with an outreach event. So we're going to have an Easter egg hunt. There's going to be food. There's going to be vendors out there. We are actually going to be hosting a table there, and there's three ways that you can get involved. Wednesday, we will be filling up the eggs from 10 to 12 at Summer Park Apartments. Friday, we're going to have the event. If you want to come out and help, that would be great. To help coordinate the egg hunt, pastors are going to be there at our resource table. We're going to be telling them about what we have going on, our community meal and more that's coming up, VBS, our picnic, so many things that we can invite them back to. Another way that you can get involved is if you cannot make it on Wednesday or Friday, I ask for prayer to make good connections with our community.
to love on them and to be the light and the love of Jesus Christ, that his light shine through us. So with all that being said, Butler Church, grab yours. We need our peeps out there, and that's you guys. So if we could have one, two, or maybe three, or four, five, six people sign up, you can meet me at the courtyard after our service. Let me know how you would like to get involved. Remember, the youth just learned about being selfless. Let's model that to them, to our church, and to our community, and share God's love. Thank you.
Continue with our baptisms this morning. I'm going to invite Martha to join me. It's been a joy to get to know you, Martha, over these last couple of years, and a blessing to meet you and your children and to see your faith and your commitment to him. And this morning, I want to ask you the same questions. Do you believe that Jesus is the Son of God, the Son of God and Savior of the world?
Yes.
And do you commit to follow him and to give your life to him?
Yes.
Amen. Upon your confession of faith, I baptize you now in the name of the Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. Jessica to come. Jessica, it has been a joy to know you as well and your two beautiful children, and to have you with us in Common Ground and serving. What a joy to have you as part of our church family. And this morning I want to ask you, Jessica, do you believe that Jesus is the Son of God, the Savior of this world?
Yes.
And do you commit and declare you're following him, your commitment to him, to follow him with your life?
Yes.
Upon your confession of faith, and now baptize you in the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Welcome, Gaylene. What a joy to have you and your sister both baptized today and to become part of our church. And this morning I ask you, do you believe that Jesus is the Son of God and Lord and Savior of this world?
Yes.
And are you committed to follow him and to obey him and to lead a life that is under his lordship?
Yes.
Upon your confession of faith, I baptize you now in the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. Now, Leticia, it's so good to have you here to share this with your mother on this day. What a beautiful gift.
My son is here.
And your son is here as well, and what a joy to know you and to hear your testimony and to have it join ours. Do you believe that Jesus is the Son of God and Lord and Savior of this world?
I do, yes.
And do you make him Lord and confess that he is Lord and Savior of your life?
Yes.
On your confession of faith, I baptize you in the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Thank you.
I'm so short.
Kelly's just tall enough for us here this morning. I like to give Kelly a hard time. We go back some time now and
been
a part of Butler Church your whole life. And what a joy to be here this morning to baptize you and to ask you, do you believe that Jesus is the Son of God and Lord and Savior of this world?
Yes, I do.
And do you confess that he is Lord of your life?
Yes.
Upon your confession of faith, I now baptize you in the name of the Father, Son, and Holy Spirit. Joseph Rios, and your heart and passion for God these days have been an encouragement to me and a joy to see and to witness, and thankful to have you here this morning, and to baptize you is a privilege, and ask you as well, do you believe that Jesus is the Son of God, Lord and Savior of this world?
Yes, I do.
And do you confess him as Lord and Savior of your life?
Yes.
Upon your confession of faith, I baptize you now in the name of the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit. God is good. And the water's great. So we're ready for more. Be in prayer. Be considering, is this next step for you? Who else is next? Who's coming? We want to see God's kingdom grow. We want to see lives transformed. What a joy to baptize these folks, to welcome them into membership. It is time to rejoice. Amen.
Hi.
Is good all the time. Amen. So today I want to start with Luke 6:38, New Translation. Give and you will receive. Your gift will return to you in full, pressed down, shaken together to make room for more, running over and poured into your lap. The amount you give will determine the amount you get back. So, we give generously because that's what the Bible teaches us. Even it makes us uncomfortable, like Chan said earlier, right? Zip lining. Even though she's scared, uncomfortable, but because she's the leader, she gotta do it. So, in that case, we want to be obedient to God. The blessings of God will follow our obedience of God. So let's pray and ask God to bless this offering. And I'm going to pray that God would bless everyone who obediently gives to his purposes. And at this time, I would like to invite our ushers to prepare for this morning's offering. And this offering is going to our general budget, unless otherwise marked. Okay. So let's pray. Lord, we come before you today on this Palm Sunday to present our tithe and offering to you in faith. We believe your word, and we honor it by putting our faith in action through our giving. We thank you for your blessing, and we believe we will have what you promised. Lord, may this offering extend the work of your kingdom in your church, your community, and into the beautiful world which you have made. In Jesus' name, amen.
And let's sing together, Blessed Assurance, Jesus is mine. I'll let you stay seated, and you can sing that as you're seated.
Blessed assurance, Jesus is mine. Oh, what a foretaste of glory divine, heir of salvation, purchase of God, born of his spirit, washed in his blood. This is my story, this is my song, praising my Savior.
Burst on my side, angels descend. Welcome, Butler Church. Bienvenidos. Quiero invitar a Chris, by Chris to read the gospel portion for today. It's one of the young men from Amor y Fe. He will read. You can follow. Puedes seguirlo en español. Va a leer Juan 12, del versículo 12 al 16. Lo vamos a leer en inglés, así que sígale usted la historia en Juan 12, del 12 al 16. Chris.
Good morning. I'm going to be reading John chapter 12 from verses 12 to 16. It says, Jesus' triumphant entry. The next day, the news that Jesus was on the way to Jerusalem swept through the city. A large crowd of Passover visitors took palm branches and went down to the road to meet him. They shouted, "Praise God! Blessings on the one who comes in the name of the Lord. Hail the King, hail to the King of Israel." Jesus found a young donkey and rode on it, fulfilling a prophecy that said, "Don't be afraid, people of Jerusalem. Look, your King is coming, riding on a donkey's colt." His disciples didn't understand at the time that this was a fulfillment of a prophecy, but after Jesus entered into his glory, they remembered that what had happened and realized that these things had been written about him.
You pray for us?
Yeah. Dear Heavenly Father, my Lord Jesus Christ, Father, our Lord Jesus Christ, Father, I come to you here, Father, just giving you thanks, my Lord Christ, Father, for letting us all be here today, Father. I give you all the glory, Father, and I just ask you, Father, that you may bless each and everyone here, Father, that you may help us understand your word, Father. Help us take it into our lives, Father, and help us be more like you, my Lord Christ, Father. We give you all the glory. We give you all the thanks. In your name, Jesus Christ, Father, I pray, my Lord. Amen and amen.
Gracias. Hallelujah. Praise the Lord. Hallelujah. Estoy muy contento de estar aquí. I'm so happy. Thank you, Pastor Scott, for allowing me to preach, and all the pastors. And I want to start with something funny. Quiero empezar con una historia alegre para alegrarnos en este día. Amén. Y esta es la historia de un pequeño burro, Pepe. Ahí lo tienen. Un aplauso para Pepe, por favor. Un aplauso para Pepe. So this is the story of this donkey is Pepe. And Pepe was the donkey that Jesus rode on that day, the historian says. And Pepe had his first service as a Uber for the city. And Pepe was so happy, he was moving his head. Can you do it like me? He was moving his head. I know. He was happy. And after that day, he rode those 10 blocks, and he went home, and he was really, really happy. He was coming home and said, Mom, you don't know what happened. And the mom said, "What happened to you?" And he said, "Mom, I might be somebody famous, Mom. Mom, something happened. I was going through the city. I did my first Uber, and this man, Jesus of Nazareth, came on top of me, and I was riding and moving my head, and people started cheering for me. And they say, we love you, we adore you, you are special, save us. Mom, they throw flowers and palm branches upon me, and I was so happy, I must be somebody important in the city." The mother said, no, Pepe, something must be wrong. Why did you go back to the city and walk again and see what happened? Mama, I tell you, I am really famous, but I will do it. So he went, moving the head. Have you moved the head? And this time, nobody paid attention to Pepe. They ignore him. Even a man said, little donkey, what you doing in the middle of the street? Get out. So he went home and said, Mama, I'm so sad. What happened, Pepe? Mama, nobody pay attention to me. They ignore me. Even a man told me, get out of the street. So the mother said, I understand now, Pepe. This is what happened. Because without Jesus in you, you are just a little donkey. And I think that's very interesting for us, no? Without Jesus, we are a little donkey. So the question is, do you have Jesus in you? Ask the question to your neighbor. Do you have Jesus in you? Or you are just a little person? Amen. I know a wife said, you are a donkey. No, don't say that today, okay? So we were reading the gospel in John 12. And I want to pay attention only to one verse today. I know Jesus was coming to enter triumphant and people were celebrating him. Sé que Jesús entró y todos lo celebraban. Y es una ocasión donde Dios permitía que él fuera celebrado. But I want to pay attention to one of the words that is in verse 15. That's coming from the prophecy from Zechariah chapter 9, verse 9. Jesus was coming, and that donkey, he was accomplishing a prophecy from Zechariah chapter 9, verse 9. Él venía sobre ese burrito porque estaba cumpliendo la profecía de Zacarías 9:9. Que decía, no temas, hija de Sion, he aquí tu rey viene montado sobre un pollino de asna. The prophet says, don't be afraid, people of God. See, your king is coming, sitting in a donkey. He was coming in peace. Bringing yourself in a donkey was not a sign of the warrior or conqueror, was a sign of coming in peace. Jesús venía no como un gran guerrero en un caballo blanco, sino que venía montado en un burrito, en señal de paz. So he was coming in peace. But the statement of, do not be afraid, don't be afraid, I think it's important for us today. Pero creo que esta cita, no temas, es muy importante para nosotros. So the title of the message today is, don't be afraid, just believe. El título del mensaje hoy es, no temas, solamente cree. In Amor y Fe, I ask people to preach with me. So tell somebody, don't be afraid, just believe. Dile a alguien, no temas, solamente cree. Don't be afraid. It's a common and important statement of God in the Bible. You will find it many times. Some people say 365 times. No, but there's many hundreds of times that statement is in the Bible. La palabra no temas en la Biblia es una palabra muy importante en relación de Dios con la gente. Algunos dijeron que eran como 365 veces. Pero no, pero sí hay muchos cientos de veces. It's very common and important. A number of verses speak about don't fear, don't be anxious, don't be afraid, don't be discouraged, don't dismay. Muchos de estos versos hablan de no temas, no estés ansioso, no tengas miedo, no te desanimes, no decaigas. And I think God's loving language towards us always involves saying, don't be afraid. Y creo que muchas veces el lenguaje de Dios hacia nosotros siempre envuelve no temas. I didn't bring my clock, so you had to tell me because, sorry, I forgot it's over there. I can preach here till next Sunday, so it won't be very good. Tell your neighbor, don't fear, just believe. It happens everywhere. You tell your neighbor, don't fear, just believe, and nobody says anything. Don't be afraid, just believe. Dile a tu vecino, no temas, solamente cree. So the reality is that we all want to rejoice all the time. We want to have the Zechariah 9 promise where it says, rejoice! That's the top of the line of exuberant happiness. But sometimes we got to go to the bottom part of this, that the spirit change in this passage in John 12:15 that it says, just don't be afraid. You see, sometimes we are on the top of the mountain. Sometimes we are just barely at the border and said, okay, it's okay, but don't be afraid. In life we face a lot of needs. And with the needs we face the temptation also to give in to the spirit of fear. The Bible speaks about the spirit of fear, the force. Maybe in the testing of our faith. En nuestra vida todos pasamos por momentos donde pasamos necesidades y también con las necesidades viene la tentación a caer bajo el espíritu de temor. La Biblia habla de un espíritu de temor. Yeah, the hard time of testing of your faith. El tiempo duro donde se prueba tu fe. When we face the challenge of an unexpected negative health report. Cuando sentimos que llega a nosotros un reporte de salud negativo. Or in the face of a financial problem that with no possible way out. A veces llegamos a encontrarnos con un problema financiero donde no hay salida. Or when we face a toxic relationship problem in our family. O cuando enfrentamos una relación tóxica en nuestra familia y no sabemos qué hacer. Sometimes we don't know what to do. We feel insecure for not knowing the answer and how to overcome. Sometimes the enemy called addiction. No sabemos cómo enfrentar aún el enemigo adicción. Oh yeah, there's a lot of Christians that we don't know how to face some things. Muchos cristianos no sabemos cómo enfrentar cosas. Y tenemos miedo. And then we face fear. Sometimes the fear of condemnation. Even we are forgiven. A veces el miedo a la condenación, a pesar de que sabemos que somos perdonados. The fear of dealing with my low self-esteem. I cannot be strong. El miedo de lidiar con mi baja estima, porque no sé cómo enfrentar todo esto. So we are tempted to be under the oppression of the spirit of fear that always speaks defeat to us. Entonces nos tentamos de caer bajo la fuerza destructiva, opresiva del espíritu de temor que siempre habla derrota para nosotros. Marcelo, ¿cómo está? Y todo esto viene para que no creamos. So all this comes so we can quit believing. And sometimes we are praying in faith and trusting for the answer, but it seems that everything is getting delayed. Go sideways. A veces oramos y estamos creyendo en fe por una victoria, pero de repente todo se demora, se va para los costados. And that's what happened to a man called Jairus in the Bible. You can read it in your house, Mark 5. Who came to Jesus to get help for her little 12 years old daughter. She was agonizing. Eso es lo que le pasó a un hombre llamado Jairo. Lo puedes leer en Marcos 5 en tu casa. Vino porque su hija de 12 años estaba muriéndose en la casa. And Jesus agreed to go to Jairus' house. He was on his way to do a great miracle, but something happened. Jairo, con la compasión, fue movido a ir y hacer un gran milagro por esta niña, pero algo ocurrió en el camino. Jesus was stopped by the faith of the woman that came just behind from the crowd and touched him, touched his robe. Jesús se paró por causa de una mujer que con fe vino detrás de la multitud y tocó el borde de su manto. So Jesus stopped to hear the testimony and tell the woman, daughter, your faith made you whole. Go in peace and be healed from your disease. Jesús se paró y le dijo a la mujer que escuchó el testimonio, le dice, mujer, eres sana por tu fe, ve en paz y queda libre de este azote. But time was running and was running fast. Some friends came and told Jairo, why do you bother the master? Your daughter is dead. Pero pasaba el tiempo y Jesús se detuvo y vinieron unos amigos de Jairo y le dijeron, ¿qué estás haciendo, Jairo? No molestes más a Jesús. Ya tu hija murió. But Jesus heard the negative report and told Jairo this powerful statement. Pero Jesús escuchó lo que le dijeron a Jairo y nos trae esta poderosa cita. Jairo, don't be afraid, just believe. Y le dijo, no temas, solamente cree. Dile a tu vecino, no temas, solamente cree. And Jesus went to Jairo's house and brought the little life to the girl, and the girl was living again. Jesús fue, ¿se acuerdan? Le dijo, Talita Kumi, niña, levántate. Y la niña se levantó delante de todos. But also as this happened with Jairo, fear comes to discourage us telling the same. Pero como le ocurrió a Jairo, el temor muchas veces viene y nos dice exactamente lo mismo. It says, it's too late. You won't make it. You can't escape this one. You are done. El enemigo viene y te dice, es tarde, no la vas a lograr. De esta no vas a salir. But remember this morning the words of Jesus. Don't be afraid. Just believe. Pero recuerda las palabras de Jesús. No temas. Solamente cree. So my brother, my sister, you can choose today to believe in Jesus. Not in me, in Jesus. So hermano, hermana, amigo, hoy tú puedes escoger creer en las palabras de Jesús, no en mí, sino en las palabras de Jesús. Remember, I just another Pepe. Jesus is with me. I could be moving my head. Look at how people applaud me. My wife says, you're the donkey called Pepe. So Jesus is telling you, don't be afraid, just believe. Jesús está diciendo a ti, no temas, solamente cree. And sometimes we are scared of God's way of doing things. You know, seek you first the kingdom of God means God has a way to do things. Seek you God's way of doing things. That's scary. Muchas veces sabemos que Dios obra de maneras extraordinarias. La Biblia dice, busca el reino de Dios. Y eso significa, busca cómo Dios hace las cosas. Yes, sometimes it's scary. We don't see a way. We don't feel a way. No vemos una salida, no la sentimos. That's because he always uses extraordinary ways to make great works. Eso porque Jesús siempre usa maneras extraordinarias. And since we are not familiar with his ways, we may feel insecure. Y como no sabemos esas maneras, nos sentimos inseguros. We know that he's in complete control, but still we fear. But remember, Jesus is telling you and me, don't be afraid, just believe. Help me preach today. Tell your neighbor you will make it. Tell, it will be okay. Be generous, say somebody. Maybe the person beside you is suffering. Tell, don't be afraid, just believe. You will make it. God will help you. Dile a la persona que está al lado con compasión, lo vas a lograr. No temas, solamente cree. And believing fear is a sure enemy of spiritual joys. And if it's not dealt with and conquered, we have problems. Fear sets our hearts trembling and our knees knocking. It's only cured by constantly fixing our eyes on Jesus. So church, see today your King is coming in peace and bringing peace to you. We may not see fire from heaven. We may not fall under the power of God or shaking or laughing or whatever. But let me tell you something. He's coming to help you. And he's telling you, just don't be afraid. Only believe. We may not see the fire, or we don't feel the shaking, but remember also, we are called to walk by faith and not by sight. Dare to believe. Fear comes by hearing the negative words of impossibility from the enemy. El miedo viene escuchando esas palabras negativas del enemigo. Fear will make you feel limited, will stop you, will block you, will oppress you and put you doubt and unbelief. But if you receive the words of Jesus, we'll put you in another position, in a position to believe and see his salvation in you. No prestes atención a las palabras del enemigo. Don't pay attention to the negative words of the enemy. Don't be afraid. See, your king is coming in peace. Believe. Remember that on this Palm Sunday, we remember that he went as the Lamb of God to face the cross for you and for me with passion and suffering to conquer all, even death. Remember that God rose him again, and we'll celebrate that on Easter Sunday. And he lives forever to give you not a temporal peace, but an eternal peace and eternal life. I want to finish mention some of the times, only a few times, where God was telling people, don't be afraid. And maybe when you listen to these promises, you may take it for you this morning. Voy a nombrar algunas promesas donde Dios habló a personas y le dijo, no temas. For example, in Genesis chapter 15, verse 1, when Abraham felt that there was no reward for his good deeds, God told him, Abraham, don't be afraid. I am your shield and your very reward. And maybe today you feel like a little discouraged and fearful because I've been doing all I can and I feel there is no reward in my life. I see challenges and situations instead of having a shield. But God is telling you and you and you and me, don't be afraid. I am your shield. Joshua had to be a leader of the great, great conquest. And God told him, Joshua 1:9, just be strong and courageous. Y quizás tú tienes que conquistar algo poderoso y Dios te dice a ti también esta palabra. No te desanimes. And maybe you had to conquer the promise that God gave you. And he's telling you the same. Be strong and courageous. Don't be afraid. Don't be discouraged. For the Lord your God will be with you wherever you go, even to the hospital. Even when you cry in your solitude, he said, don't be afraid. I will be with you always. In 2 Chronicles chapter 20, verse 15, three enemies were coming against the people of God. Jehoshaphat called for fasting, and a prophet rose up and said, this is what the Lord says to you. Don't be afraid or discouraged. For this great army, because the battle is not yours, it belongs to God. Let me tell you, this is true for you also. You are not alone battling sickness, family problems, addictions. Don't be afraid. He will make a way out. Daniel was seeing all this revelation and said, oh my God, all the strength get out of me. The angel appeared and told him, Daniel, don't be afraid. Because since the first day that you start praying, with understanding and you humble yourself, your request has been heard. Tú a veces piensas que tus oraciones no se escuchan y tienes miedo. Dios le dijo a Daniel, no temas, tu oración ha sido oída. And then in Daniel 10:18, the angel looked to Daniel and touched him, and he received strength. And once again, the angel told Daniel, don't be afraid, for you are very precious to God. Peace, be encouraged, be strong. And I know that's for you and for me. You just can put your name over there. And you can read like this with your name. You are very precious and loved. Don't be afraid. In Acts 27:23, Paul was ready to go to Rome to be in front of Caesar. And there was a great storm and tempest. And the angel came and told Paul, Paul, don't be afraid. Surely you will go to Rome. So Paul shared this testimony and said, take courage. Because I believe God, it will be just as he says. I finish with this. 1 Kings 17, Elijah said to the widow, don't be afraid. Go ahead and just do as you said. But make something first for me. Because this is what the Lord says. There will be always enough. God says to you and to me in Isaiah 41:10, don't be afraid, for I am with you. Don't be dismayed, for I am your God, and I will strengthen you and help you, and I will uphold you with my righteous hand. I invite you to stand this morning. We will pray. Quiero que te ponga de pie. Vamos a orar esta mañana. Maybe you are dealing with this oppression of fear. We all go through that. Don't you feel that Jesus, when he felt that nobody was there, even he said, Father, Father, why don't you let me alone over here? That's the greatest fear of all. But he conquered it. We want to pray together. If you are dealing with fear, I invite you to raise your hand if you want. But we want to pray together. If you don't want to do it, it's fine. But I encourage you to touch somebody this morning. Touch somebody. Be a prophet of the highest God. Touch somebody and say, don't be afraid. Just believe. Toque a alguien en esta mañana y vamos a orar y dígale, no temas, solamente cree. Pray with me and pray for somebody. Father, in the name of Jesus, we thank you this glorious morning, Lord. Because it was on purpose that the Holy Spirit changed that word in John chapter 12, 15. Yes, Lord. There's moments to rejoice. But also moments where we just hear your voice that says, don't be afraid. Only believe. Bless your people this morning, Lord, as we enter in this holy week, and we will celebrate your passion and suffering, and then we celebrate your resurrection and conquest of everything, even death. Touch those that are afflicted. Touch those that are facing great infirmities and problems, Lord. We know that you came in a donkey in peace. Sometimes we expect somebody more powerful, signs and fire, but we know that in your peace, we have the answer. Touch your people, hear your people, bless your people this morning. Tell your neighbor, touch him and say, the Lord is with you this morning. Don't be afraid. just believe. Dile a tu vecino, no temas. Solamente cree. And if you have fear of death, death has no power on you if you have Jesus on you. And if you never made Jesus the Lord of your life, you can do it today. Just say this word with me. Put your emphasis and meaning in your heart. Whatever you are, just say, Jesus, I receive you today. I declare that you are my Lord and Savior. I believe that you are the Son of God. And I believe that the Father rose you from the dead. Enter in my heart and give me eternal life forever. I love you, Jesus. Thanks for your forgiveness. I receive abundant life in the name of Jesus. Amen. Amen.
It's been a wonderful morning spent together to worship, to share, and to hear testimony, to witness the beautiful act of baptism, the declaration of faith, and a proclamation of the word, and an encouragement to us to not be afraid. I'm thankful for a Lord and a Savior that knows what it means to travel dark and difficult paths, that he would go and to the cross give his life for us and conquer there sin and death in his resurrection, revealing to us once and for all where true power lies, where new life is found, and it is in Christ. And we heard this morning already testimony and saw in the baptisms a testimony to that hope and that faith and that trust in Christ. And I want to invite those that were baptized this morning to join me here up front. If you want to line up here in front, they have so bravely shared testimony and stood before you, and we want to officially welcome them this morning to membership and invite the pastors to come. Terry and Nixon, would you come as well as a representative of Asian Grace? We want to welcome these folks into membership. And before we do that, want to recognize, we call it membership. And why is that? It's one of the metaphors in Scripture for the people of God, the followers of Jesus, the church. The metaphor is that of a human body. Is this body functions, this church functions as a human body. And in the human body, it has a head. And we learn in Scripture that head is Christ. But the body is not just the head. It is all the parts, all of the members of that body. If you lose a part of your body, we say that is dismembered. It's not a word we like to hear in that sense, but now today we celebrate the membering, or maybe the remembering, of these amazing people to join this body, to be members, not members like they're members of Costco or the gym, but of a living, breathing organism that is the church. And they are part of a wonderful, thriving body of believers here, and now we grow and are blessed by their addition to our ranks, and they are blessed by you as members of Butler Church. And so this morning, before we officially welcome them, I would like to invite you as members, if you are a member of Butler Church, they stand before you ready and willing to be part and to be members, to be a part of this body, hands and feet. Would you as members stand as a recognition of them and as an affirmation of their joining us? Would you stand and see together we are one body, many parts, uniquely and wonderfully made from different walks of life with different gifts and experiences, together trusting God, leaning on one another. What a wonderful gift that Christ has given us in the church through his Spirit, through his love, through his death and resurrection. Would you bow with me in prayer? Heavenly Father, we thank you for this moment in which we get to welcome new members to this body, this living, breathing body.
God, we're thankful for the life that you have given us, the ministry you have given us, the impact to be made in this corner of Southeast Fresno. Lord, we pray that you would continue to allow us to be effective in growing and connecting and growing this body stronger and healthier and more complete. Those that know you, that maybe don't even know they're disconnected at this point, God, that they would be able to connect, to become part of your family, of your church, of your body. Father, we're thankful for each one that has joined us today, for their testimony of the great and wonderful things you have done in them and how you have led them, their testimony to their belief and commitment to you. God, may we surround them as a church family, protect them and care for them, help grow them and mature them, and may they do the same to us. May we together grow further and further in your love, in our faith, in our joy, and in your kingdom. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. Amen. You may be seated as we share these certificates and a handshake of welcome to Giovanni. Welcome. Amaris. Joseph. And Kelly, Gaylene, and Cindy. Wow. Leticia and Virginia. Jessica and Martha, welcome. Blessings to you all. Thank you. Thank you. What a privilege to welcome you as members of Butler Church. You all get to know them, but maybe they don't really know this whole sea of faces out here. So be sure to introduce yourself. If not all today, it can be a bit overwhelming. But throughout the next weeks, would you introduce yourself? A warm hello, maybe an invitation to coffee or lunch might be in order. Let's get to know our members of Butler Church and love on them and care for them and get to know their story and share ours with them as well. Thank you all. You may be have a seat. Lead us in worship and we'll close with a benediction.
Well, we have one more Palm Sunday song to sing. If you'd like to follow in your hymnal, it's number 333. Let's stand as we sing together, Hosanna, loud Hosanna, just like the people of Jerusalem did.
Hosanna, loud Hosanna.
It's been a joy to be together, and I want to remind us that there's more time to be together. In the bulletin, you'll see an invitation for next Easter, or next Sunday, which is Easter. And we want to encourage you to share this with a friend, with a neighbor. Stop by the office and get more. Would you like to share with all your neighbors an invitation to return and to worship with us in our regular schedule, in our four congregations and multiple cultures and languages, a celebration of the resurrection of Christ. And before that, on Friday, you're invited to come on Good Friday at noon for a special service here as we reflect on Christ and the cross and his journey there. We will reflect together in that, and then also in the afternoon, remember, we're going to serve across the street at the Summer Park Apartments to help and come alongside and love on our neighbors and invite them to join us to Easter service. So keep these things in mind as we continue to go forth and praise his name and to trust him, to lean on him, to not be afraid, but to believe in what all the good that he has done, the good things he has done, and the life that is found in him. Would you bow with me in prayer? Heavenly Father, we thank you for this wonderful time that we could share together. Lord, you are a good and mighty God, an awesome God, who loved us so incredibly much that you would send your own Son into this world, Father, to know us, to love us, to die for us, to take upon his shoulders the weight of sin and death. Those things which capture our hearts and fill us with fear, you took on firsthand, and you know them. Father, you even surrendered to them and allowed your Son to be crucified on the cross. God, we're thankful that you are a God who knows us and knows our pain and knows our fear, our brokenness. And we're thankful, God, that you are a God who is mighty to save, and whose Son did not remain in the grave, but conquered sin and death, all that we could ever fear, and rose again to new life, a life that is available to us by faith, by belief, by confessing and living our lives out in trust and hope in you. Father, may we embody that. May we receive that and reflect on that this week as we go from this place. May you be glorified in our lives, in our words, in our actions, in our coming and going. God, may your kingdom come. May your will be done in us and through us. Amen. Amen. Thank you so much for joining us this morning. You are dismissed.